celebrant for this morning's Mass is Father Fred. And let's stand in worship together with our opening song, Rain Down. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The apostles and presbyters, in agreement with the whole church, decided to choose representatives and send them to Antioch with Paul and Barnabas and Silas, leaders among their brothers. This is the letter delivered by them. The apostles and the presbyters, your brothers, to the brothers of Antioch, Syria, Cilicia, and of Gentile origin, greetings. Since we have heard that some of our number, who without any mandate from us, have upset you with their teachings and disturbed your peace of mind, we have with one accord decided to choose representatives and to send them to along with our brother Barnabas and Paul, who have dedicated their lives to the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. So we are sending Judas and Silas, who will also convey this same message by word of mouth. It is the decision of the Holy Spirit and of us not to place on you any burden beyond these necessities, namely, to abstain from meat sacrificed to idols, from blood, from meats of strangled animals, and from unlawful marriage. If you keep free of these, you will be doing what is right. Farewell. And also they were sent on their journey. Upon their arrival in Antioch, they called the assembly together and delivered the letter. When the people read it, they were delighted with exultation. The word of the Lord. the gospel of the Lord. How many students are familiar with the word representative? Have you heard that word before? If you have, raise your hand. Okay, good. I see everybody in their classroom raising their hands, so you can put your hands down there. You can put your hands down there. A representative, a person chosen or appointed to act or speak for another. There are many ways we represent one another. We can do it through speaking, or we can do it through symbols. So if I put this mask on, who do I represent? Who do you think? Who do you think I represent? Right, St. Catherine. As a matter of fact, when I came here in August and September, I was shopping at Menards. And, you know, I had my mask on, and someone came up to me and said, "You're from St. Catherine." And I said, "Well, how do you know?" And they said, "Because of the mask." I thought, "Oh, that's right." Boys and girls, sometimes we forget who we represent. And in today's first reading, there was a misunderstanding. And so with one of the communities that were becoming followers of Jesus, and so St. Paul and Barnabas got some representatives to go to that community with them to say, "You were not given the right information. Everything's going to be okay. Everything's going to be okay." So it's really important to have good people who speak on your behalf, good representatives. And we represent more than we really realize. We represent St. Catherine Parish, but we also represent our families. Well, how is that? We think about your family name. You think about your family name. So when someone says John Smith or Mary Smith, people will think of the Smiths. They'll think of your mom, your dad, your brothers, your sisters, your grandparents. You represent your family. But the important thing I want to talk about today is that we represent who when we come to church. Why do we come to church? We come to church to hear whose word? Whose word do we? Whose word?
God's
word. We come to hear God's word. And who do we receive in the body of Christ when we come up to communion? Who do we receive in Holy Communion? Go ahead. God's body, but who more specifically? Who's his son?
Jesus.
Right? So we receive Jesus, and we receive him in the Holy Eucharist. And so when we receive him, we're supposed to go out into the classroom or out into the world after school, and who do we represent? Jesus. We speak for Jesus. That's what a disciple does. And so when we're baptized, we begin our journey as a disciple. The disciple is one who follows Jesus, who learns from Jesus, right? From the Bible. And we go out and we represent Jesus. Well, how do we do that? Well, we've received him in the body of Christ. We've heard his holy words. There are many ways we represent Jesus. Kindness, peacefulness, mercy or forgiveness, understanding. So there are many, many ways that we can represent Jesus, just as the disciples of old did with the faith community, where there was a problem. They went in, represent Jesus, and say, "Okay, everything's going to be okay. Let's be kind about this." And they brought a sense of peace because the people were really upset. So sometimes we when you see two people arguing, the best thing you can do is be a person of calmness, be a person of peace. Don't add to the argument, don't add to the fight. And when you do that, who do you represent? Jesus. Jesus. So today, what's one way that we can all represent Jesus, as Paul and Barnabas said the disciples did? And I think the biggest thing could be helpful is be kind. Represent Jesus through being kind. Even when somebody maybe says something not nice, don't add to it. Don't make it worse. Be kind. I really think that's the best thing we can do to represent Jesus. Most things kind, peaceful, loving, forgiving. And let us offer our petitions, the things we want to pray for our whole world, our nation, the United States of America, and our community of faith. So let us pray for the representatives of Jesus, namely being the Pope, Pope Francis, namely being the bishops and the cardinals, that they may always show us as disciples of Christ how to be kind people, loving people, peaceful people, building Jesus' kingdom. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for our nation and all of our leaders, especially those who are in need, a little bit more peaceful, a little bit more kindness, representing the needs of all people, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for our faith community, that as we celebrate this season of Easter, that we may be people of new life. Let us pray for all those people who may be in need of kindness and those people who may be struggle today. They may have an illness or a disease, or they may feel lonely or forgotten. For this, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord.
And for the prayers we hold within the quiet silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord.
Gracious and loving God, help us be the best representatives that we can be, bringing your kindness, your peace, your joy, your love into the world, as we offer up all our prayers through Christ our Lord, and so we say amen.
Amen. Amen.
Gifts, O Lord, we pray, and accepting the obligation and and oblation of this spiritual sacrifice, make us an eternal offering to you. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. God, our loving Father, we are glad to give you thanks and praise. Because you love us with Jesus, we say the following: Glory to God in the highest.
Glory to God in the highest.
Because you love us, you gave us this great and beautiful world. With Jesus, we say, Glory to God in the highest.
Glory to God in the highest.
Because you love us, you sent Jesus, your Son, to bring us to you. Gather us around him as the children of one family. With Jesus we say, Glory to God in the highest.
Glory to God in the highest.
For such great love, we thank you with all the angels and saints as we praise you in song.
Holy, holy, holy.
When supper was ended, Jesus took the cup that was filled with the fruit of the vine. He thanked you and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Jesus has given his life for us.
Jesus has given his life for us.
The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Lord our God, listen to our prayers. Send all of us to share in this meal. May the Spirit bring us closer together as the family of the Church, with Francis, our Pope, and Blaise, our Bishop, all other bishops, and all who serve your people. We praise you, we bless you, we thank you.
We praise you, we bless you, we thank you.
Remember Father, family, and friends, and all those who do not love us, we should. Remember those who have died. And we pray for our mass attention this day for all of our students' religious education, our school, our teachers, and our families. Remember all those who have died. Bring them home to you to be with you forever. We praise you, we bless you, we thank you.
We praise you, we bless you, we thank you.
Gather us all together into your kingdom. There we shall be happy forever. With the Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and our Mother, her spouse, St. Joseph. Here all the friends of Jesus the Lord will sing a song of joy. We praise you, we bless you, we thank you.
We praise you, we bless you.
Thank you.
We will walk with each other, we will walk.
yet partakers of the gifts of the sacred mystery, humbly imploring the Lord that what your Son commanded us to do, in memory of him, may bring us growth and charity through Christ our Lord. Gospel reading talked about love. And what love is all about is that you care for another person. You want what's best for them. Even when things don't go well, you don't want to wish them any harm. And so what we really represent is Jesus' love. When we are called to be disciples, we receive the body of Christ. And so, like I said, the homily, a way to represent Jesus' love is through a little bit of kindness, a little bit of understanding, a little bit of mercy. So let us think about, well, how can I best represent Jesus today? Peace the Lord be with you.
Your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and proclaim the good news.
Thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God.
Take the word.